It's just before dawn in southern Iraq. A small convoy of vehicles heads out across the desert. Joining the team is archaeologist Sebastian Ray. He and his colleagues are traveling 200 miles south of Iraq's capital, Baghdad, heading for a set of ancient ruins which could unlock the origins of civilization itself.
Archaeology is truly amazing here. Every morning I have this excitement of maybe this is the day where we will find something truly exceptional.
The sands of southern Iraq hold a unique place in human history. 6,000 years ago, a people called the Sumerians built the world's first cities here. They vanished, but for reasons that are still unclear, their civilization influenced the stories of the Bible, written thousands of years later by a very different people. According to Genesis, this is where the world began, the setting for the Garden of Eden, the Great Flood, and where the descendants of Noah built Erech, a mighty city. Today, biblical scholars identify Erech with Uruk in southern Iraq, a huge Sumerian metropolis older than the pyramids. Uruk had temples studded with intricate stone mosaics and developed a maze of streets filled with mud brick houses. Widely seen as the world's first true city, 6,000 years ago, this was a revolutionary way of living. Why were the Sumerians the first people to build cities? And what was the world of Genesis really like? The first Westerners to uncover Iraq's lost cities were inspired by the stories of the Bible, but archaeologists have still barely scratched the surface of what lies buried here. These rare aerial images show the sheer scale of Uruk's sprawling ruins today. Sebastian Ray from the British Museum belongs to a new generation, working alongside Iraqi colleagues and driven by science. Our cameras have unique access to follow their groundbreaking dig at a neighboring site called Girsu. It could shed new light on how the first cities like Uruk evolved.
Girsu in the third millennium BC was a very, very big city. We call it a mega city, and it was home to more than 20,000 people.
The Sumerians, like the ancient Egyptians, built on a massive scale. The team is uncovering a very unusual structure. It's colossal and unlike anything ever found in ancient Iraq.
This construction is a very unusual plan, almost in the shape of a big X.
Sebastian works with archaeologist Ebro Toron. She investigates the strange design.
This is a very interesting structure, built actually like two symmetrically arranged convex walls. We have studied the structure almost brick by brick, and we know that it was made of fire bricks. It must have been a very useful structure because it was kept maintained for many, many centuries.
Archaeologists once thought this structure could be a tomb or even a temple. But it stands inside an ancient canal. These are actually the foundations of a bridge, built from thousands of mud bricks with bitumen as mortar. This structure was once 26 feet high and up to 130 feet wide. It's a small bridge by modern standards, but when it was built 4,000 years ago, it was revolutionary. It's also an ancient water management system. By squeezing the current through a narrow channel, the water picked up speed without raising the level downstream. A testament to Sumerian ingenuity. The bridge is the oldest ever found in the world. Could it reveal why the Sumerians invented cities?
This structure is not only a very impressive archaeological ruin, it also tells us a lot about how people, Sumerians, actually found solutions to live in this climate. It's a unique structure.
The bridge is the first hint that this arid land looked very different in biblical times. Sebastian works with geoarchaeologist Jafar Jatheri to reconstruct Girsu's original environment.
No more these canals around it.
Together, they fly a drone to look for more canals like the one with the bridge. Work that would take months on the ground takes minutes in the air.
Using a drone is really important. We used to use traditional way of survey and excavation, but now we are now actually discovering lots of things. If you have high technology and you can plan well where to excavate or where to dig.
From above, the desert looks flat and featureless, but it hides remarkable secrets.
So this image is made up of more than 100 drone photos. The main large straight lines you can see are ancient canals.
The drone survey reveals that water surrounded Girsu in ancient times. This desert city was the Venice of its day.
We always had this idea that a Mesopotamian city, any city like Uruk, like Babylon, is strongly connected to one river course. But here, in the case of Girsu, there are numbers of canals that run across the site, but also through the site.
Conventional wisdom says that the construction of these canals led directly to the birth of the first cities. An extraordinary vase, discovered at Uruk, reveals how they allowed the Sumerians to turn the desert into fields. The vase depicts farmers who carry baskets overflowing with crops. A herd of goats and sheep graze freely. It's a fertile landscape that some believe might even have inspired the story of the Garden of Eden in the Bible. Genesis describes how a stream running from Eden flowed into Iraq's life-giving rivers, the Tigris and the Euphrates. Some scholars believe the name Eden itself may come from the Sumerian word for a plain or open country. But no one knows for sure if this theory about the rise of the first cities is correct, because few have ever tried to date these canals. Until now.
Our knowledge of ancient Mesopotamia is very limited, and it dates back to 50, 67 years.
Sebastian's team uses an ingenious technique to find out exactly how old the canals are and if they were dug at the same time as the city was built.
But one way of dating an ancient canal is to collect shells from the bottom of those canals. We can radiocarbon date the shells, and this would date the canal itself.
The team analyzes more than 20 shells. The results reveal a staggering surprise.
These are the first results we have from the lab. The range of dates for the earliest large-scale canal is roughly from 6000 BCE to 4500 BCE.
The canals appear to predate any Sumerian city by at least 1,000 years. It means that settled farming cannot be the spark that led to places like Uruk.
So if we assume that the model that everyone agrees on today, that Uruk, the famous city, is the first city, these canals are 1,000 to 2,000 years earlier than this very important date. This would significantly change almost everything we know about the rise of the city in Mesopotamia.
Everything we thought we knew about the dawn of civilization could be wrong. Something else must have motivated people here to build cities. Why did people leave this real-life Garden of Eden for life in a big metropolis? A clue could lie at the center of Uruk with a vast temple, the world's first pyramid.